Did you know eating someone else's poop can actually be good for your health? It might sound gross, but a fecal microbiota transplant is something an estimated 10,000 Americans do at home each year. The procedure is done by transferring stool from one person to another, often orally, and it's done to fight infections associated with diarrhea, abdominal cramping, and even fever. We're talking to a principal investigator in a fecal transplant study to learn more about this procedure and understand why anyone would want to put someone else's poop in their mouth.
This treatment isn't new. It's been around for a long, long time. And there's stories of people who in the 1950s would give people, you know, slurries of stool in a milkshake or on a sandwich.
Fecal transplants are believed to date back to over 1,700 years ago. During the 4th century, Chinese scholar Gehung made yellow soup from fermented stool to treat diarrhea. The treatment even made its way to World War II, where German soldiers switched it up a bit and ate camel stool to treat dysentery. Today, the procedure is used to treat Clostridium Difficile Infection, or C. diff, a bacterial infection that affects the colon. C. diff can weaken patients' immune systems and affect their treatment for things like pneumonia, cancer, and other illnesses. Each year, the illness affects 450,000 Americans and kills close to 30,000 within 30 days of diagnosis. C. diff is traditionally treated with antibiotics, but this doesn't always work, as antibiotics could also kill good bacteria, worsening the patient's condition and making it more likely for the infection to return. Our digestive system is home to thousands of bacteria, both good and bad, that are released in our stool. So the theory is, when you eat healthy poop, the good bacteria ends up in your gastrointestinal tract, which could help to knock out the C. diff.
The idea is if you put maybe good bacteria in, they then will kind of take over and kind of compete with the C. diff for resources and kind of grow and kind of crowd out the C. diff. That's called niche exclusion. Another possible mechanism is that the good bacteria come in and they themselves produce antibiotics as a byproduct, which are effective against C. diff. And there are more kind of complicated mechanisms that they're looking into that have to do with our body's metabolism of bile and bile acids.
With 125 procedures done since 2011, researchers at Mayo Clinic in Phoenix say they have a 90% success rate in fecal microbiota transplants. The procedure can be done in three ways with a stool slush. It can be freeze-dried and placed in a capsule for you to swallow, placed in a tube that is then pushed down a patient's nose, or administered anally through an enema or colonoscopy. Fecal transplants are just now being done professionally, but they were actually first adopted by DIY communities. Fun fact, with the popularity of fecal transplants on the rise, dropping a deuce is now becoming a side hustle. Companies like Open Biome pay $40 for a stool sample and $50 if you drop off poop 5 times a week. So you can make up to $13,000 a year off something you would flush down the toilet anyway. The pre-screening process is rigorous though. Only 4% of potential donors are accepted. Researchers say acquiring stool for transplant is similar to the process of donating blood to a blood bank. Donors are asked questions about their health, given blood tests, and must have no GI conditions. And all of this is done before the stool is sent to a lab for further rigorous testing.
Fecal transplant is now supported by the Infectious Disease Society and the GI Society in Europe and in the US, as it's strongly supported in treatment for multiply recurrent C. diff infection. Most big cities, big hospital systems have one or more providers that are offering fecal transplant. There's a fecal transplant foundation that tries to maintain a list to help people find someone near them. So if you are suffering from recurrent C. diff, if you've had two or more recurrences, if you've failed to improve even after a long course of vancomycin, you know, most would recommend fecal transplant at that point.
Fecal transplants have shown promising results, but there are still many unknowns. Researchers at the AGA Center of Gut Microbiome Research and Education currently have a study underway that will track 4,000 people who've received transplants. The study will follow these patients for 10 years and explore the effectiveness of fecal transplants as well as its long and short-term effects.
Now there's nearly 200 clinical trials worldwide looking at fecal transplant for all different kinds of conditions. I think the next one that's shown some, you know, signal of benefit is ulcerative colitis, which is a form of inflammatory bowel disease. Further afield, they're looking at it to other autoimmune diseases, obesity. Everybody's looking for something for that. If you could take stool from a skinny person and lose weight. But, you know, I think all of those are much more complicated. C. diff was the low-hanging fruit.
So if a fecal transplant seems like a possible treatment for you, make sure you consult with your doctor, as you should with most health issues. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's episode of What the Facts. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, make sure you hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Got a weird body science question? Shoot your shot, drop a comment below, and who knows, we might cover it. Be sure to catch more of this season every Tuesday.